Okay guys, today we're talking about the Aquaphor Healing Balm Stick, and I need to clear something up right away. This is not a moisturizer. I know everyone calls it one, but from a skin science standpoint, that's not what it does. And once you understand how it works, you'll use it way more effectively instead of just slapping it on dry skin and wondering why it didn't fix anything. Let's get straight into this, guys. All I ask from you is just to hit the like button down below. It tells YouTube this is worth showing to more people. So if you like learning about health from a scientific perspective in a calm and collected way, consider subscribing too. So here's the deal. Moisturizers actually add water to the skin or help your skin hold on to water. Aquaphor doesn't really do that. The main ingredient is petrolatum, which is an occlusive. That means it creates a seal over your skin and locks in moisture that's already there. No water going in, just preventing water from escaping. That's why if you put Aquaphor on bone dry skin, it can actually feel greasy without making your skin better. Let's talk about what's actually inside this balm, because this is where Aquaphor gets underrated. The first is the petrolatum. This is the main ingredient, and yes, it's petroleum derived, but it's also one of the most studied and effective skin barrier protectants we have. It can reduce water loss from the skin by up to 30 to 50% or more, which is huge for healing compromised skin. Second, it's the avocado oil in here. This is where Aquaphor gets a little fancy. Avocado oil is rich in oleic acid, which helps soften the skin and support barrier support. It also contains vitamins A, D, and E, which help calm and nourish this stressed skin. It doesn't hydrate on its own, but it supports skin recovery. Then it's the shea butter in here. Shea butter is an emollient, meaning it smooths and softens the skin surface. It also has natural anti-inflammatory compounds, which is why it feels so soothing on irritated or cracked skin. Again, not a hydrator, but a powerful comfort ingredient. Okay, now that we've gotten that out of the way, here are three smart ways to actually use the Aquaphor Healing Balm Stick. First, slugging it the right way. This is probably the most common use, but most people mess it up. You want to apply the stick after your moisturizer, not instead of it. Cleanse, apply your hydrating serum or moisturizer, and then lightly swipe Aquaphor over areas that lose water the fastest. Think your lips, around the mouth, sides of the nose, and under the eyes. What this does is seal everything in and dramatically reduce transepidermal water loss overnight. That's why people wake up with plumper, calmer skin with this stick. Second, healing and barrier repair. Aquaphor is incredible for compromised skin barriers. If you're using retinol, exfoliating acids, or you overdid it with actives and now your skin feels tight, stingy, or flaky, this is where the Aquaphor really shines. Petrolatum has been shown to reduce water loss by up to 30 to 50%, which gives your skin tone time to repair itself. Now, you can use the stick directly on irritated patches, your cuticles, cracked knuckles, which happens, your heels, which is a great place to put them, or even over a healing pimple once it's closed. This isn't about treating it. It's about protecting so your skin can actually heal itself better. The third way to use it is targeted protection, not all over shine. This stick format is actually genius because it keeps things precise. You could use it as a wind and cold barrier on cheeks and lips, especially in dry weather. Runners use it to prevent chafing. Some people even use it a tiny amount to tame their brows or protect the corners of their mouth if they're prone to cracking. Again, guys, this isn't skincare fluff, it's physical protection. Now, quick reminder of what not to do with it. Don't use Aquaphor as your only skincare step. Don't expect it to hydrate your skin on its own, and don't layer it under active ingredients. It can trap them and cause irritation. This product works best as the final step, not the first step. So if you've ever said Aquaphor didn't work for me, chances are you were using it like a moisturizer when it's really a skin sealant. Once you use it correctly, it becomes one of those boring but brilliant products you keep reaching for. Also, send this video to someone you know who recently bought the stick or has it so they know how it's properly done. If this helped you understand how to actually use this one, hit that like button too. It really helps the channel, and subscribe for more science-backed skincare that actually makes sense. And until then, guys, I'll see you on the next one.